My workflows really evolved because when I started, there were no samples, and I started composing films in 1986. So I've gone the gamut with notation programs and now samplers and workstations and samples and all that. So the way I worked, because mostly I work with live orchestra, is I set up in my template, in my workstation, I use Logic. I set up every different articulation with every instrument listed traditionally the orchestra with the woodwinds and the brass and everything, and each articulation separate. And then and I do everything in my workstation. I don't sketch or do any of the things that I used to do now. I write directly into into Logic and then orchestrate as I go. I used to, when I started, I would write in a full score anyway because I didn't like sketching because my handwriting was so bad. So I had some experience of doing it that way. But this is sort of a growth of that. And because you have to have mock-ups for everything, no matter what, classical music, anything you do now, you need a mock-up. It's what we call it. I don't know what Europeans call it, but yeah. And so the better and more flexible the samples are, the better it is, the less work it is. I noticed that sometimes it's very hard work to make something sound correct, and lots of things with samples don't, when they're notated, they don't look the way that they sound, or they don't sound and look right. So there's a lot of that kind of manipulation, but there's also a lot of manipulation with the samples to try to make certain kinds of articulations in certain specific instances sound right. So it's getting better and better and better, but the more flexible and realistic it is, the better it is for me, for the composing part of it. And like I said, mostly I record with orchestra. This is just to write and to show whoever, the director, whoever I'm working for, what it's going to sound like. Yes, a lot of it does. I have to print a lot of things. And mostly it's the non-traditional instruments, the different sorts of, you'd call electronic samples or certain kind of organic ethnic sampling things. But it's a whole big combination of stuff. I do a lot of live recording actually right in here with guitar or percussion or various things. And then once in a while I will keep some of the samples to go along with the live music as well. Again, it's very specific to the actual piece of music and the actual film. And so you have to be really flexible. It needs to be a very flexible environment. And the hardest thing about it is you know what you want to hear, and sometimes it's very hard to get it, you know, to get it. It's particularly for me, the string, different sorts of bow articulations are the trickiest thing for me. Mocking up can make you think something's well orchestrated from the mock-up, but it's really not, because something sounds too much bigger than it's really going to sound, and it's a process of figuring out what your samples are telling you. You know, you want it to sell the cue to the people that are listening, that are going to decide, is this music okay? But you're also using it for yourself to write and to orchestrate. So there's a lot of different things that you need. So you do need a whole lot of flexibility with it, and you need some experience with it. And the better it is, what I find with most samples is is they tend to sound bigger than they really sound in reality. There's a certain thing in reality that it's hard for samples to get, though they are getting better and better and better. This library in particular, I think, is really flexible. It seems to come from a more classical music point of view, which is basically what film music is anyway. I mean, it's basically a 19th century orchestral construct. I mean, that's even with all the pop music idioms and all the stuff that you use, there's still almost always some kind of 19th century orchestral type of music in all these films. And I think you guys are really thorough about it too, because it always seems like the articulation that you want doesn't seem to be there. And I think you guys have really pretty thoroughly gotten pretty much all the articulations. You have lots of the, you know, you have the kind of obscure orchestral instruments, the bass flute I think you guys have a E flat contra wood bass clarinet. I think you guys have done, yeah, and obviously the tubins and the all those kinds of things where a lot of the libraries don't have that. But all that stuff, it's great because you can do all that stuff live as well. Using these older instruments or instruments that are a little marginal in an orchestral environment, certainly like in LA, you can find anyone to play any of these instruments. So it's another reason that it's a interesting library for me, Vienna. It's hard to say. It definitely influences your process. And like I said, it can trick you. If you're going from samples to live, right? It can trick you and make you think that something that isn't what it seems like you're hearing. I don't know if I'm really in a position to answer that, because for me it's been such a long, slow evolution. Like I said, I started with just, I'd compose on the piano and I'd write into full score and I'd orchestrate, as I go. And then I started using notation programs, but essentially they were like big music word processors. They just made it clean and easy to edit and people could read it. And then in the 90s, in the early 90s, where you sort of, everybody started to, have to mock things up, I started mocking things up. And it started to a degree change the way I wrote, but I'm not quite sure like how to quantify that or qualify exactly what that meant. It's easier to incorporate popular music idioms and elements. It's changed what film music has become, because it's made film music, in my opinion, more egalitarian in a good way and in a bad way. It means that you don't need to be able to read music to write music, which I think is good and bad. It has a good side and a bad side. And I think it's definitely changed the way film music is now. So without getting into a big philosophical discussion, I would say that technology has definitely played a role in where music in film, and I would venture to say even new classical music, is going. It's very technology based, So whether that's good or bad depends on your point of view, and I guess the person also using it, how they use it. But to me, it's progress. Progress is progress. I mean, it can't be bad to have a really good sample library that you can make sound like a real group if that's what you want to do. Of course, you can make it sound like anything else as well. So that's easy. I think it's hard to make it sound like what it really is. And I don't think it's supplants anything. I don't feel like it's a putting people out of a job or anything like that, though I guess to some degree it does. I think it brings a lot more people into the fold that it wouldn't. So it has a very good side that way as well.